you know, MSPs that have these established customer relationships, they're trusted advisors, they've known their clients a long time. In many cases, despite, you know, this COVID cycle we went through, we're still walking into those client offices, right? And shaking hands, understanding their businesses. But the reality is that a business that does that, right, is not necessarily geared up. And you did mention this early on, to have that expertise to be watching all of these panels and differentiating and saying, okay, this is an annoying thing that happens to a machine, but it's ignorable. This is an alert that should probably be cleaned up, but it's not a compromise. This is a compromise that needs minor cleanup, but the impact is not great. Oh wait, this one's a breach and we need to do lifecycle management. And not only does the MSP need to get called, but probably the client needs to get called now, right? And so as an MSSP, you're bringing that skill set to the table, and that set of people, right, as an overlay, right? And so MSPs don't have to build that up themselves. They work with FutureSafe, and you're bringing that overbuild, right?
We manage all the alerts, right? We respond to them, and we operate behind the scenes. So we never talk to the MSP's clients. There's never a reason to. We communicate to the MSP, and we deal with it that way. But yeah, we deal with dropped agent tracking and agent updates and what we call rogue scanning, where we scan for machines that don't have the proper agents but should. You know, we give CyberCNS away to our clients for free. I'm CyberCNS as CISO, and we do all their support, so I can do that. Where do we go now? We have the protections in place. Where do we go to have the right tool sets to build the compliance things that we need to build, but also we need to recommend to our clients? We're not getting in that space. Why? Because we're not experts at it. We do this thing over here. I recognized that there is a fundamental difference between an infrastructure skill set and a cybersecurity skill set. And to be able to provide that skill set to the end client, particularly if you're an MSP, can be incredibly difficult. And hiring people with the requisite cybersecurity skill set is quite a bit more expensive than most MSPs can manage, right? And you know, I think if you ask our clients, and we had a marketing team query our clients for this, was what's a value proposition? And really the value proposition isn't that we can sell a license for this, that, or the other. The value proposition was being able to be, you know, that cybersecurity trusted advisor to the MSP themselves about what they were putting forth to their client. And yes, we provide a full stack of services that the MSP can get from us and sell to their client, but that's a byproduct. That's not the root cause of it, right? It comes down to having cybersecurity expertise that, you know, you're not paying for in a, you know, consumption basis, because you have these platforms that you're selling the client anyway. The whole premise behind partnering with a white glove MSSP is that we're there to remove as much of the risk and liability from you as possible, and to put you in touch with the right vendor partners who can get you where you need to be. You know, look, for what we do at the end of the day, like Brian's talking about, you know, we are the cyber provider, white glove, fully transparent to the client, doesn't know we exist, doesn't need to. For those MSPs that recognize that they don't want to do it or have no business doing it, a lot of our clients come to us because they don't want the liability. And there's plenty of margin with every product they get from us to still make good money. If it wasn't, we wouldn't be in business and be successful.